Roar! Or whatever.
I don't even know if I have any other pieces missing. None of them are numbered or labeled in any way. And this is basically a disaster. That coupled with the fact that my audio is not working, I think I'm going to scrap this review and contact the company and try again. Which is too bad because I was really excited to build a Brachiosaurus. Okay, Dino fans, I did contact Amazon and tell them that my model was missing some pieces, and they sent me another one, which got here a day sooner than they said it would. So let's try this again, and hopefully this one's not missing any pieces. I do have the model at least partially assembled. I will say that the connections are really hard to push together, and some of them don't want to push together very much at all. It doesn't have a whole lot of flex to it. So you just sort of have to push really hard. And it's actually making, like, if you see my hand, how red it is, it's actually making my hands hurt to assemble this model. You can see that the instructions are very simplistic. Nothing is labeled. There are no numbers on the bones to tell you which ones to go together. You have to guess. And guess how they go together. I can't say I'm enjoying this model as much as I enjoyed some of the others that I've assembled. Yeah, the instructions for the base just say put it on the base. It doesn't really have this way. It doesn't actually have any flat spots to put the feet in, at least not that are aligned with the feet. We'll skip the base, because as you can see, it stands just fine without it. So as you can see, I do have a completed Brachiosaurus skeleton. As far as assembly, like I said, it hurts my hands to push the pieces together. That's how hard I have to push. The pegs seem to be made just a little bit too big for the holes that they're meant to go into. Honestly, you could remove the pegs and use glue to hold it together. That might be a better option. The head came off several times while I was trying to put the tail on because I had to push so hard to get the tail on. And then the tail came off when I was trying to put the head on. I finally got them on there. As you can see, it's together. My main issue with the Edu Toys brand, in addition to having pieces that are a little bit more cheaply made, obviously, and don't quite fit together properly, is the instructions. The instructions are too simplistic. The bones are not numbered or labeled in any way. You have to guess which order to put them together in. You also have to guess which way they face. They tried to, on some of the bones, make a round peg and a square peg and a round hole and a square hole, but I had to fight so hard to get them to go together. By the time I was done, the square ones were all mangled and in some cases, you can't even tell the difference between the square one and the round one because they're the same size. I think that's probably less a design flaw, more a manufacturing flaw. Perhaps if Edu Toys had a better manufacturing process or something, they could make better quality. At the very least, the thing I would suggest is a rewrite and some improvements on your instructions. and also to use the opportunity to add some educational value, because it doesn't even say leg, head, foot. It says nothing. It just has some pictures with some alphanumerics. So, the other thing that's really bad is the base. It's basically the equivalent of a Halloween mask. It doesn't even look like it was made for this figure. It doesn't have flat spots where this figure could fit. And it's so cheap and so lightweight, I feel like it could break at any moment. It's certainly not going to stand the test of time. Any amount of hot weather or sunshine and this thing would crack immediately. This is definitely a piece for display only. As far as being an accurate Brachiosaur skeleton, it's close. The bones themselves, being made of dark plastic and then covered with a coating of a lighter color, the pattern is not consistent throughout the whole model, so you have some places that are dark black and some places that are like opaque beige, so the application of that could have been done a little better. It will stand and it will display. I'll have to come up with my own base for it. Compared to some of the other model kits I've seen, I feel like this being $20 was a bit much for the quality. But it's cheaply made, which, good for them, they can get a lot of profit out of it. Being so hard to put together, I would not recommend this for any child under the age of 8. Certainly, it says age 8 on the box, but I even had trouble and I'm in my 30s, so you may have to assist children in putting the pieces together, and hopefully when you're done, you have something that at least looks like the Brachiosaurus the way it's supposed to. You can see already the tail is starting to come back apart. You have to push really hard to get it to go together in the first place, and then it doesn't stay. As soon as you push together one joint, the next one comes off. So, watch out for that if you end up with an Edu Toys model. You may wish to use some glue to secure the joints. I was hoping for something a little bit similar to the T-Rex Paleontology Kit from Mattel, so that I could have a T-Rex and Brachiosaur skeleton display for my visitor's center compound from Kenner. But this model is probably not it. This model is not posable in any way. That's the stance that it has, and that's all you get. It's also way, way different in color to the T-Rex model. I'd have to repaint it to get it to work. And for the purpose of that experiment, I would say that this did not work at all. Which is unfortunate, but at the same time, every experience is a learning experience, right? So hopefully I've learned something here and I can help you not have to do this. So, Mattel, if you are watching, please make a Brachiosaur. I know you're making the colossal Brachiosaurus toy that I so desperately, desperately want. Make a stem kit, too. That would be super awesome, because yours are way better quality than what I found on the market so far. And unfortunately, that's all the time I have for today. I hope that you've enjoyed this video. I hope that you have at least learned something from it or taken something away from it that is valuable to you. Again, this is the Edu Toys Brachiosaurus Skeleton Model Kit. It's a 23-piece model for ages 8+. Unless you're just really desperate for a Brachiosaur model at a $20 price range, I would skip it and look for something else. Meanwhile, don't forget to press the like button and subscribe to the channel for more content. And until I see you again, happy hunting!